all I could do was pray. I put it in God's hands. It's easy to do that. It's easy to pray for your children. It's easy to pray for your friendly neighbors. But you got to pray for the neighbor that is not friendly to you. And you got to pray for the person that cuts you off in traffic. And what I want you to do, I'm not going to ask you to change your lifestyle just by listening to a 20 or 30 minute sermon. But I want you to try something for 7 days. All right? You go today, day one, and next Saturday, day seven. And just try it for 7 days. I want you to pray at the beginning of your prayer for who might be your enemy, or who is persecuting you, or what is persecuting you. And do that for 7 days. Now, my belief is that after you do that, you won't want to stop it. You will notice that your outlook has changed, that your heart has changed, and you won't want to go back to just praying for those that love you. You want to, your prayer time will get bigger. And you don't have to just go in your closet and pray. You can pray while you're driving. I pray all the time. I'm taking my daily walk. I'm praying. I do things I shouldn't do. I'm praying. Do things I'm supposed to do. I'm praying. It can be all the time. When I prayed for others I was hearing, it would just come to my mind and I would just say, God, save me. So it can be any time. But I think if you do that, you will see a change in your life. And you won't want to go back to just praying for the ones that you love. So 7 days. Think you can do that? All right. So that is the first step in never stumbling. Goodness. And I gave you one standard. There's many more in the Bible. We could spend days just dissecting how to be good. But there's just one. Raising the level of our goodness from where we think it is good, that quick list of things I gave you, to where what God sees as good. God sees goodness at a whole different level than we see it. And someday when there's a new heaven and a new earth, and we're walking with God every day, we will really understand what goodness means then. But until then, what we can do is raise our standard. And I think the first step would be to raise our standard by praying for those that might persecute us or be our enemies. So that's step one. Now I'll give you a little insight for the next one. The next one is knowledge. Right? Knowledge of Christ. And I get to tell you the next one, I will tell you the one thing you need to know about Jesus. If you don't know anything else, but if you know there's one thing, your life will never be the same. It'll never be the same. And the hint for it is from 1 Corinthians chapter 15, verse 3 through 6. And I thought I'd do this too before I close out. There's seven things in there that we need to talk about. Let's give you a heads up on what they could be. Knowledge of Christ, the next one. Self-control. When I was in the Navy, I would see young men come into a disciplinary review board just about every time after they were able to go out drinking, and their excuse was, well, I was drunk. They were out of control. Perseverance, life's hard. How do we get through it? There's things in the Bible that shows us how to do it. Godliness. Participating in that divine nature of godliness. Mutual affection. Brotherly love, some translations say. Vallejo type of love. And then the final one, love. The kind of love where your neighbor says, hey, you're a match and I need a kidney, and you give them a kidney. I joke about my friend Mike. He's the kind of friend that I say, the kind of friend you have that if you need a kidney, you give him a kidney. The kind of friend that would jump on the candle for you. Those kind of stories. That's the kind of life that when I look at. So, that's what's in store in this little package of seven verses or so. A rubric for success. A rubric for being a faithful Christian. A rubric for being a good person. A rubric for being a person that just sticks out. Because that's what we are. We're the called out ones. We're called out to be different. And if we're doing those things, they'll see it. If we're taking care of ourselves, they'll see it. Let me pray for you. Our Father in heaven, we thank you for this congregation and for this group of called out ones that want to be more like you and want to be perfect like you. Father, we just ask you to watch over us and strengthen us when we confront our enemies and our prayers and those that persecute us, and we accept your judgment on whatever it is that they do, and we don't try to judge them. Father, help us to please ourselves so we can be a great congregation of ministers of this community, and loves this community, and all from that other.